Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind English Amiga. I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari, back with another episode. Let's see if we can finish exploring Twin Lake in this episode. This is the Dancing Dragon? Dancing Dragon right through that door. See? Now you believe me. There's a wine cellar with slimy blob things down there for us to fight, but we're not gonna do that yet. We could. I don't know our chances, but I'd rather improve our chances. There's two of us, which helps. Okay, we're over here, which was the exit here? No. I didn't realize there were two exits to the city. So it's still this area we've gone. And all that over here. Basically I want to turn around then. Where did I even come from? Where's the merchant that we came from? Yeah. Oh, it's saying that this is an exit, not a merchant. Okay. Because that's the Dancing Dragon. Alright. That misled me. But now we know. So now I think we linked everything up here. We still have this area. Too bad I can't wheel the mouse. So we're pretty much eliminating everything here. We have this way to check out, and then basically we want to head to this part of the map because so basically head down and make a right. Which way, actually? Yeah. Turn right at the merchant. Something down here, just could be a bunch of stuff, or I basically want to head left and see if there's anything there. It goes to another part of the city, I believe, then. Hello? How do you do? The wizard says, ah, I see. You are in a dangerous quest. Here's some advice. Use sparingly any objects possessing magical powers. Mostly these things have magical charges, and when the charges are used up, the object falls to dust. Yes, you've been watching or playing a lot of D&D. So I definitely did not see you before. Okay. So it is a different part of the map. It's funny how it just, I don't know. There's a doorway leading to nothing. Just more of the city. So basically there's nothing here but to talk to this guy. Kinda weird. But okay. Alright, so we need to make our way back. Again, I'm clicking this, guys, because it's just the keyboard doesn't always respond to me, unfortunately. So I headed straight out. I could go all the way up and turn. kind of wondering about this block here, though. Is that weird? I guess I'll go all the way up and turn right. And then all the way down. Alright, and we've seen up there. So basically we want to move, I think we're facing the right way, we want to pass the first left and hit the next. Do we know what this is? Merchandise, yeah. We've been there. Alright, what we got up here? The plaque says, Idla Food. Open from 8 to 18 hours. Well, let's see if that's a good time. My price for a ration of food is 15 gold. Yeah, no. Okay, so now we got a merchant. This is the part, this really reminds me of old style Ultima. Because basically you'd be walking around on this map, not having it be the auto map. Continuing! Another door! Another door and another door. Oh, let's go in. I don't know what it is. It's into another section. It's into a dead end. I don't know what the purpose of that is. Doors that lead to nowhere. Waste my time with doors that lead to nowhere. Am I headed the right way? I don't even know. No, I've been that way. About face. Oh, you're very excited. Who is this? Hello, kitty. Sunny. Oh, she's only 14. I didn't mean cutie that way. Hello? Oh, you scared me. Have you seen Felix? Dunno. Who the hell's Felix? Felix is my cat. He was kidnapped a short time ago. We were coming from the marketplace in the evening when suddenly a dark figure with terrible claws grabbed him and disappeared. I followed the shadowy figure to the graveyard. I couldn't go any further because there are ghosts in there. In the graveyard. At midnight, a shining figure appears at the grave of Sir Marillion. If you could return Felix to me, I would tell you of my greatest secret. Really? Okay. Tell me your secret now. No, no. I will only tell you when you return Felix to me. Alright, so at midnight, perhaps? In the graveyard. But that's when Sir Marillion appears. I mean... supposedly. See if she knows anything about anything. See, she mentioned Marillion, but she knows nothing about Marillion. Oh, you scared me. Have you seen Felix? Or she won't repeat. Good thing I have these videos. Okay, the details are in here, that's right. A dark figure with terrible claws grabbed him. And followed the figure to the graveyard. Alright. Well, well. So what's through here? Another dead end? Just the same dead end. Is that her again? Yeah. Hi. Just exploring dead ends. Huh. Don't mind me. Now, have we been this way? Okay, so we have a few quests to do. We have not been that way. Let's go that way. There's a door. You were standing before the house of your parents. Memories bring tears to your eyes. There's a mapping out things, guys. I wonder if this displays as anything on our map. Door. No traps. House door key. Ah! The item opens the door! Eric's Revenge plays. Like an awesome song. What is this? What is that? Oh! This is the camp. That's cool, it has its own little theme too. What is this with the... Oh. I saw a black square. This is the door to your old room. It'd be cool if you could look at everything, but alas. Oh, I'm hurting myself against this plant or whatever it is. Now that looks like a chest. In the chest before your bed, you find some things you can use. Yay! 98 gold. Okay. Give how much gold? Do I have to do it? Can I hit 98? No. Are you serious? Okay, I can go like this. Now, how do I actually give it? I hit exit, and then I have it? Who do I want to give it to? My own self. Okay, we got clothes and two torches. Standard clothes. Okay, I'm assuming these are the same. Just torches. They're 500 grams. Transfer which item? I think silk can hold on to that. One for silk. One for me. See, it's empty. We can't even look at it. So now we have 123 gold. That's nice. Anything with this? Nope. Alright, well that was worth it. Gold, man. What other rooms do we have in here? There's a lot of doors in this house. Back out to the hallway. We're standing before a door with a very small lock. Alright. A Guess we'll come back to that. No time to be sitting around. Have you been through all of this? Making sure. Yeah. See, once in a while you hear that weird dissonant key. Another chest? In this chest, you find a small key and an old robe. Okay, I found a small key. Tiny key. Shield of two. Okay. I should probably put that on. Okay, so the clothes have a shield of 1,000 grams. The robe has a shield of 2, but it's 2,000 grams. Heavier, but... Wrong class to use the item. Okay, never mind. I figured a robe for a magic user. What the hell? Nothing else in here, I suppose. Alright. Now, I want to use that key, but let me just go look at the rest of the house first. Because I'm pretty sure there is much that I have not explored here. I basically ran in here. This is the entrance. Can we have this mapped out as well? Oh, there's no auto map. Alright. This is like the Great Hall or some crap. Oh. On the wall in front of you, there is a picture which has been in your family for generations. The special feature of this small picture is that it changes during the day. Perhaps it can be useful to you? Perhaps. Magic picture. Special item. Now I think this might be what tells you what time of day it is, for some reason. See anything obvious, maybe when you go outside. Okay. Nothing else there, okay. Alright, let's go use our tiny key. Or small key, minuscule key. They do have two different names for it. This, right? Tiny key. Bloop. Old school, man. When you use keys, they disappear. Can you imagine if that happened in real life? Where am I? Where'd I go? Oh, I was hidden behind the door. Amongst your father's things, you find several items you can use. Yeah. At least several. Nice. I'm liking this. We got a potion. Two potions. It's either an M or an H. Short sword, leather boots, a buckler, chainmail, and a bunch of arrows. potion. I guess we have to get this identified, because we don't know what it does. Melee weapon. Who can use the boots? A wizard can! I will wear the boots. And why did it say it's unusable by my class? I guess because I have no class yet? I'm like school in summertime, no class. Because I haven't decided. There's nothing that says I'm a wizard.
You're a wizard, Amethyst.
Alright, so basically... Yeah, transfer. One for silk. One for amethyst. The silk can hold these things. Oh, got knocked out of that? Oh, I made that my active character. Transfer which item? Yeah, it didn't work, huh? I must have clicked something wrong. Giving him all the arrows. She can have the boots. I wonder if he can wear this stuff. Gold? Oh, we need this. Give how much gold? You can distribute the gold evenly by going like that. So this way, Silk can carry some gold. Nice. He has 675 gold. It's just 447. We got a lot of gold all of a sudden. It's awesome. So these leather shoes are... Yeah, shield 1. And these are 3. So... Ta-da! Now, who can use these again? This robe. I guess because I don't have a class yet? Wrong class to use the item. I guess I need to be a class first. I don't know. Well, the magic picture is here. Ah, we needed to do that. This item now fulfills, spelled wrong, a special purpose. Right. Now we can see that it's nighttime. Awesome. Always good to know. It's nighttime. So that's our house. We found much gold here. Now let's finish exploring Twin Link. You can definitely see it now. Looks like we don't have much left to explore. So we're facing this way. Alright. I want to make a left. Here be unexplored stuff. I think we've been here though. Let me just check. Merchandise, yes. Been passed this place several times. He's at a good location. Okay, there's that other area, I think. Let's go this way. What have we here? The large iron plaque shows in golden letters, Guild of Warriors. I wonder if they'd be open at night. Welcome to our guild, what can I do for you? Nothing much. 30... I need 30 experience points for the next level. I'm not a warrior. Now, as far as what I've heard in this game, you can't multi-class. It looks like as though you can, because you can just go to different guilds and take levels. But I think you're locked into that, I'm not completely sure, or you don't gain benefits from it? Not sure about that. But I'm not going to multi-class, so... It's moot in my case. I never like multi-classing, dual-classing. For whatever reason. It's never been my thing. The brass plaque says audiences available at all times in urgent cases. Signed, Lord Chancellor Carwain. Chancellor is that way? Let's go this way. Does this say the same thing? Adventurers wanted. Please contact the Lord Chancellor, signed Lord Chancellor Carwain. Okay, where are we now? So this... The Chancellor's here. Let's finish going around here. Looks like it goes a loop-de-loop here. An exit. Let's just see if we... Yeah. I want to hit that exit, though. Let's see what's through there. I'll hit Chancellor Carwain last. You are standing before an oak door. Strange runes are cut deeply into the wood. That's interesting, we didn't... Did we pass this already? We didn't get that message? Or did we come up through here, I think? We came up through there. Strange runes, huh? The House of Shandra! A note is hanging on the door. Gone fishing, back around 8 o'clock. Please make yourself comfortable. Okay. I am doing that. I'm gonna sit at all your tables. Oh, there's a picture? There's another special picture. An old yellow map of Lyramion is hanging on Lyramion is hanging on the wall here. Text scroll, 255 grams. So, pretty much this corresponds to the map you would find in the box, in the big box copy of the game. Who do you want to give it to? We're just taking the guy's map. Poor Shandra. So here's the map. Oh. We want to use the item, I believe. You may now use the map of Lyramion provided in the Amberstar package. It's a good thing we have permission. Now, I don't think you even need this anymore. I'm just going to hold on for it for now. At some point, you can also find the book, which is the novel, in the back of the manual. It tells you, okay, you may now read that, like, you haven't already done so. I guess that's for that added immersion. Okay, so we got a chest here, apparently. think. It looks like a chest, damn you. Alright, never mind then. Hanging around Shandra's house. Here, basically through, yeah, the way we came. Have we been in here? No, we have not. Is there something else we can... What's sitting here? Nothing. Oh, are you sleeping? Thought you went fishing. Well, before you wake up, we'll loot you blind. If I can do anything with this stuff. The door bears a brass plaque. Laboratory. No entry. Nonsense. Ah. I'll use a torch. Or not. Well, no entry. You were right. This time. Have I been through here? Yes. Is the way out? It is. So I think we'll go wait in this guy's chambers. Wait for him to wake up. Greetings! Don't you never wake- Where the hell'd you go? Where the hell are you? Oh. Shandra, 78-year-old wizard. Okay, so we've got a gray wizard, level 13. Hello. Let me look at you. Yes, you seem to be suitable. I have a long and difficult quest for you, but I don't want to rush you. In this book, I have described the history of the world and what has to be done. Make yourselves comfortable and read it in peace. I also give you this key. It fits in the laboratory door. Oh, yay! There you will find a chest containing a few items you can probably use. You can also have the map which is hanging on the wall in the dining room. Done that. I think it will help you on your travels. Say anything about Bela. Doesn't know anything about Felix. Marillion? Yeah, you don't really know much of anything, do you? Alright, never mind then. Okay, the laboratory key. And Shandra's book. Oh, I don't want to show item. No. I want to take the item. Transfer which item? To myself. And transfer this to myself. Why, thank you. So... well, these keys. Laboratory key. Keep looking to see if there's some kind of description or anything like that. There's the map. Shandra's book. Okay. So, use it. You can now read the novel included in the package. Its title is The Tale of Tarbos, God of Chaos. That's the map in the back of the manual. We can hold more items. Now, I don't know if we can scroll, like... I know there's a weight limit. You become encumbered, or you literally can't carry more than that, I'm not sure. I think you just can't carry any more than this. And, we also have a limited number of slots as well, so... Go figure. Alright, back through here. Checking out the laboratory. We need sound effects in this, actually. The room looks like an alchemist's laboratory. Barrels of herbs and minerals stand everywhere. The table is covered with glass flasks heated by candles. Oh my god. We can carry all this stuff. Magic compass, weapons power 1, armor protection, light 1, because these are scrolls. Here's another robe. Potions. Oh, this looks like from Dungeon Master. This kind of potion, like a Black Widow symbol. Okay, this is H, then this is M. Maybe this is healing and this is magic? Leather. So we got leather and studded leather and a mace. Now, I don't think we can carry all this stuff. Magic compass spell scroll. Now, what it is... I know it seems like cheating, but you miss out on a lot if you don't do this. Basically, you want to save your game and then try to use this to memorize these spells. If you fail, well, either way, the scroll disappears. If you fail, the scroll disappears and you don't learn it. And who knows when you can find that again. If at all. So, I'm going to call it an episode right here. Shoot, is there anything there? No. So it's really just this chest that we're dealing with here. Alright, so I'm going to mess around with this next episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, guys, and always, seek adventure.